Apple announced something very interesting at WWDC 2024. This is Swift can be used in an embedded environment. If you are developing an application that runs on Apple products such as iPhone or Mac, this may be very interesting news. You can create your application using embedded Swift in an embedded environment. The really good thing is probably many of Swift's features can be used in an embedded environment. Additionally, I think people who have generally developed apps using Swift can now develop embedded applications more easily. The way I see it, this is what Apple is trying to do to expand the Swift folder so that everything uses Swift. However, more importantly, I wonder if Apple will continue to support this. This could be really bad if Apple's support is cut off, so I think we need to think carefully before we start. If you take a look here, there are some differences from full Swift that we use in-app development. This means that you can still use various features supported by Swift, such as optioners, generics, collections, and error handling, but full use of Swift is not possible because the support in embedded Swift and full Swift is slightly different. We also have Swift code ready for the Matter framework, so it becomes easier to develop Matter accessories using Swift. That's also really cool. I will show you a demo using my ESP32C6 and the LED blink example provided by Apple. This is ESP32C6 DevKit C1 and 8. It has 8 MB of flash memory. Since Apple optionally used this device in their demo, I also prepared the same device. One thing is that Swift supports only 32-bit or 64-bit ARM or RISC-V, so the ESP32S3s based on Extensa cannot be used. There are many things you need to prepare to use Apple's embedded Swift. I prepared the same development environment by following the tutorial provided by Apple. I posted the necessary links in the description below. Please check it out if you need it. On the right, the required softwares and versions are posted. You need to make sure you meet this before you start. In my current environment, CMake version 3.29.5, ESP-IDF version 5.2.2, GM for Matter build is 2155, Swift version is 6.0 dev. In a Mac environment, you must change the toolchain version after installing Swift. You can select the Swift version to use in Xcode toolchains menu. You can see the all installed Swift versions here. You can also check the installed version of Swift through the toolchains identifier. To get started with Swift, you need the stuff mentioned here. It seems like it would be time consuming if you had to prepare from scratch. Alright, now let's try the example provided by Apple. I'm going to clone this project repo to my computer. Okay, it looks good. Here's a simplistic example called LED blink. Let's try this. Let me open VS Code and make some changes to the code. If I open the main Swift file here, oh man, I see Swift code. The first thing to do is change the target device to C6. By setting a target, you can see that the necessary parts are automatically built first. As you know, C6 has an onboard LED which is WS2812B. This example is a code that change the LED with a random color while blinking every second. Looking at the LED Swift file, the functions initializing the LED, turning on and off, and change the color are already defined in the class. I'm not sure yet, but I think we can implement it for other sensors in this way and easily use it in main Swift. I'm gonna add the green color to the LED color extension. In this hue saturation function, arguments are passed as a hue angle value and percentage of saturation to represent the color. With this and brightness, it is converted to RGB values. Let me modify the main code slightly so that RGB colors appear one by one rather than a random color once every second. It's been a long time since I used the Swift language, so I'm not familiar with it anymore. First, create colors as an array type of LED color type and add RGB colors here. Red, green, and blue. As you know, it's already defined in LED color extension. And I will use the color index variable to get each color from the colors array. There is a 1 second delay in the while loop toggle the LED turning on and off. When the LED turns on, a new color is taken from the colors array. Brightness is set to 50. After that, I increased the color index 1 so that it could refer to the next color. If we do this, it will change the defined color every time the LED is turned on. Let's check out. Oh, almost forgot it. Let me set the connected port. The first build of an IDF project takes too much time. Of course, unless you change components and settings, the second build will be done quickly. Let me move on. Okay, this is my first ESP Swift or Swift ESP project build. You can check some information through the terminal. The code works as intended. Each time that the LED turns on, you will see the color change. We could do something similar in C++, but I think it ultimately comes down to how much shorter and more readable the code can be written in Swift. If you are very familiar with Swift, I think embedded programming can become very interesting for you. Perhaps my next project will be to try making a Matter accessory based on Swift. I'll do some more testing and prepare a demo for this. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.